Hello, welcome to another video from Far North Bushcraft and Survival. Thank you for joining me. I've recently been doing a video series on bushcrafted camp furniture and utensils. Okay, in a recent video we split this log using bushcrafting methods by making a mallet and wedges. Okay, we made a bushcrafted bench out of it. Very serviceable. It's nothing fancy, but it works. Works good. So now the other half of the log. I've got an idea that I want to use this log for. This half log. I want to make a table. How is it going to turn out? Stay with me. Let's find out. Okay, we've got some legs here that we're working on. Now let's put them to use. Okay, now to determine the length of the legs, I sat down here and got a rough idea on the height that I want my table. Okay, and determined how far in the ground I was gonna put these, and that would help me figure out how long these needed to be. Let's go ahead and put them in and see how it turns out. Okay, that looks good. I believe that'll work out. Now let's do the other side. I'll come back when I've got that done. Okay, now notice how I have this leg off to the side and this one out in front. You know, I've got the whole thing turned, you know, not square on. And that is, the reason why is because I wanted this leg out of the way, so that you could sit here with your feet and without a leg interfering. And same with this side. Okay, now we need to lash these together. And we need to lash them together in such a way that it's easy to manipulate them, change them so that we can adjust the height of the table. So let's get started with that. Okay, there's a special knot that's going to allow us to have some adjustability on this. And that is the Canadian jam knot. And this is how it's tied. Okay, I'm going to loop this behind and tighten it up with a tag end on it. Okay, now I'm gonna do the same again. Loop the running end behind the standing end and make another overhand knot, just like we did the first time, except we're not gonna tighten this one up yet. Okay, now take the other end, run it behind the loop and through the same way. So that it comes out the same way as this end. Okay, and then tighten up your loop. Okay, now we can cinch it up. Cinch it up good and tight. Okay, so now if we need to loosen it up, you know, it's good and sturdy. If we need to loosen up, we grab this tag end and pull to loosen it up. Okay, So let's tighten it up and see where we're at as far as table height. Okay, got this good and tight. Let's put the table on, see what it looks like. Okay. There we go. Now, okay, this end here looks pretty good. Now I purposely made that end a little high, and that is so that you can see how I adjust it. So let's go adjust that end. Okay, we need to grab our tag end here and loosen it up. Okay, and do you hear that thunder? Okay, that looks pretty good right there. I think that's fairly level. Okay, let's tighten her up. Get the string lined up here. And tighten it up. Okay, let's try it out. Okay, here's the completed table. I cut off the excess that was sticking on beyond the finished table and bench. Okay, that's what it looks like. All right, now you may be saying to yourself, some of you may be saying to yourself, well, that's fine, you know, you put sharp pointed ends on these and drove them in, but what if you have a hard ground surface that you can't drive stakes in like this? What would you do then? Okay, what I would do, okay, we have a bipod here. I would make a tripod, and I would make it, I'd put the third leg out this way, okay, and I'd saw the top off so it doesn't interfere with the bottom of the log. Okay, I'd do that on both ends. I would, run the third leg out here and make the top of it short. I would use a standard tripod lashing. Okay, now the problem with that is that you go to put the log on it, there's nothing holding the base in place. The weight of the log on the top here is going to spread this out, it's going to spread the bottom out, and it's going to fall. Okay, so what I would do then is I would arrange these. I would take my saw and I would make a cut right there on the outside of each of the three legs. This leg over here, I would make a cut on the outside. Same with that log, leg over there. Okay, and I would arrange them in such a way that then I could run a string from that log to this one, through the saw cut, over to this one, through the saw cut, back over to here, and tie it off. That would keep these bottom legs from spreading. That would hold them in place. And also, you could leave these long, and leave both of these two long. You couldn't leave the third leg long because it would interfere with the bottom of the table. But leave these long and you could make a saw cut on the outside of each of them and tie a string across between them, or a cord. Well, there you go. There's the finished table. I hope you folks enjoyed watching as much as I did making it. Thanks for taking time out of your day, away from work or away from home, to come out in the woods with me today. Thanks for joining me. You guys take care. We'll see you on the next video.
If you enjoyed this video, be sure and give it a thumbs up and to share it, as well as subscribe so you don't miss any more. And check out these suggested videos here. Thank you.